don't often get to appreciate the scale of the science that's going on. You're kind of bogged down in your own world, and it's really nice to just step back, and it's actually invigorating to hear that everyone else is facing the same sort of day-to-day struggles.
Benefit is having the whole CSC together. Since we're spread right now over a couple of buildings, we run into each other, but maybe not as frequently as we should. And to have all of the science in one place at the same time is, I think, really valuable, the sort of combination of the talks and the posters to help put everything in context. Because it is also very diverse, and it's nice to see things side by side.
Saki's talk, where we find out that these what are believed to be exceptionally important mechanisms that regulate epigenetic marks have very little conservation among very similar species, and how that system has evolved over time. It's very surprising. Once people have decided that something's very important, it's assumed that every organism must do it the same way, and we're finding out more and more that that's not the case.
I really like the environment that is a bit laid back. People can talk about things in an informal way, so there's no pressure, and we can actually discuss science. So I really like that. That's the feeling I got during the poster session and during the talks. So I'm very happy about it, and I'm very grateful that people recognize my work.
It's really nice that people presented their most recent findings in depth rather than just giving an overview. But one example that I was particularly interested in was the talk from Boris Leonard, which was focusing on ultra-conserved non-coding elements in genomes, and these are sequences of DNA that over millions of years have exactly the same sequence and more or less the same position within the genome. So for example, you'd find them in exactly the same position in a fish genome and exactly the same as a human genome, and yet their exact function is not totally obvious. From the point of view of someone like me who's interested in evolution, I think it's something that's completely counterintuitive, and the work that he's doing to characterize that is extremely interesting.
I think the quality of the science at the CSC is absolutely exceptional. I think there's a lot of change at the MRC in science, and there are going to be quite a lot of economic pressures. But our scientists should really forget that and concentrate on doing their very best science, make sure it's creative, be as brave and as bold as possible, and by taking that approach, we will win out.